Welcome back to my channel. A while ago, we talked about one of the great goddesses of Celtic folklore, the Morrigan. And today, I thought I'd talk about another one of my favorite goddesses from Celtic folklore, the Welsh goddess Rhiannon. Rhiannon, the goddess born at the first moonrise, is also known as the White Witch and the Queen of Fairies. She is also known as the Divine Queen and the Great Queen, since she is believed to be a version of the ancient Celtic goddess Rigantona, whose name means Great Queen. She is known as the goddess of horses and birds, of love, fertility, sovereignty, transformation, magic, wisdom, rebirth, creativity, and inspiration. She is a queen of the Celtic otherworld, and thanks to being a moon goddess, she's also sometimes known as the Queen of the Night. She's also associated with other Celtic horse deities, like the Gaul goddess Epona and the Irish goddess Macha. Rhiannon is capable of deep magic and is able to manifest her dreams and desires. When visualized, Rhiannon is often depicted as a truly beautiful woman, riding a magnificent pale horse. She's often dressed in wonderful golden or purple gowns, and has her three magical birds flying around her head and singing beautiful melodies. But since she's also a horse goddess, she's also often depicted as a proud mare, accompanied by a foal, her son. In pagan traditions, Rhiannon is symbolized by the moon, the number 7, horses, songbirds, the wind itself, and gates. Until this point, I mentioned birds a couple of times. The birds of Rhiannon are indeed pretty important and unique. Those birds are, of course, no ordinary birds, but magical ones. The three birds are able to sing melodies that capture any man hearing it. The songs sung by the birds have the power to lull anyone into a peaceful sleep, and to even wake the dead from their everlasting slumber. While Rhiannon herself is mostly known from the tales of the Mabinogion, a collection of Welsh legends, her birds are also known outside of it, namely in the legend of Culhwch and Olwen, from the bigger myth surrounding King Arthur. In that legend, one of the impossible tasks Culhwch had to fulfill in order to be allowed to marry the daughter of the giant Yspathaden is to get the birds for the day of the wedding. But back to Rhiannon herself. She is one of the most important characters of the Mabinogion. There, she appears in the first and the third of the four branches. So, let's take a quick look at her role in the Mabinogion. In the first branch of the Mabinogion, Rhiannon is described as a strong-minded, intelligent, and beautiful woman of the otherworld, known for her generosity and wealth. The first branch of the Mabinogion is about the story of Pur, Prince of Divid. Within that story, Pur first sees Rhiannon at Gorseth Arbeth, an ancestral mount and presumably a gate to the otherworld, near the castle of Pur. Pur instantly fell in love with her. She appeared to him as a beautiful golden goddess riding a gorgeous white horse, and as he saw her riding away, he sent his men after her. But she easily outran them for 2 whole days, until Pur himself set after her on the 3rd day, and he finally managed to catch up to her. Well, that is, after politely asking her to wait for him. At that point, Rhiannon tells him that she would be happy to marry him, and that she indeed searched for him, since she was engaged to a man named Wall, whom she did not love. Well, she found Pur and decided that he would be the one at her side in his stead. Pur and Rhiannon married at the court of her father. Not without trouble from Gwal, but thanks to Rhiannon's wits and magic, they can trick him, and Rhiannon follows her husband to his castle in Divid. After a few years of a mostly happy marriage, Rhiannon gave birth to his son, Pryderi, who actually has a role in all branches of the Mabinogion, but never is much of a main character. Anyway, the night Pryderi was born, the infant disappeared without any trace. The maidens, who were supposed to watch over him, but slept through the night, were terrified that they might face a death sentence for not watching the baby. And so, they hatched a plan. They killed a puppy and smeared his blood onto Rhiannon. Waking up in the morning without knowing what had happened, Rhiannon was found covered in blood and instantly was accused of having killed and eaten her own newborn son. Since she was still seen as an outsider coming from the fairy realm, nobody believed in her innocence, and so Purr had to set her a penance. As a punishment for her deeds, she had to sit by the castle gate for 7 long years, every day, in the burning heat of summer and the biting cold of winter, and tell her story to every traveler coming along. Additionally, she also had to offer to carry those travelers on her back, as if she were a horse. But despite all this, she still kept the title of queen and sat at Purr's side at feasts. While Rhiannon endured this harsh punishment, her infant son was actually still alive and was discovered by Tiernan, the lord of Gwenda's Cot, in the southeast of Wales. But as odd as it sounds, when Tiernan found the boy, he did not find a baby, but a foal. As a horse lord himself, he was in search for foals of his own horses, which often got lost. But he didn't expect to find a foal that suddenly transformed into a baby in front of his eyes. But anyway, Tiernan gladly accepted this child and took him together with his wife into his family as his own. His new name? Guri Walt Yeren. Guri with the golden hair. Guri soon grew into a child with superhuman pace and a love for horses. But as he grew, Tiernan started to notice his resemblance to Purr, whom he knew from his time as courtier at Purr's court. And as much as it hurt Tiernan, he followed his honor and brought Guri back to court, where he actually was instantly recognized as the missing son. His return restored Rhiannon's honor and her punishment was over. Guri was then named Pryderi, which means worry or concern, and later took over his father's throne. And that was the story of Rhiannon's first marriage, in short. I will take a look at it in more detail in an extra video, but for now, this should help you to understand what a patient, strong and witty person Rhiannon was. Even though she was wrongfully evicted, she never seemed to have a grudge against her husband, or even tried to flee her punishment, even though she was a fairy woman, capable of magic and goddess-like. But let's also take a quick look at her second appearance in the Mabinogion. Rhiannon's second appearance in the Mabinogion is in the third branch, in the story of Manawydan, the son of Thir. In this story, Purr had already died, and Pryderi had become the king of Divet. After the Irish Wars, he and Manawydan had become comrades in France, and so Pryderi arranged a wedding between his mother, Rhiannon, and his friend Manawydan, while he himself married a girl named Kikfa. It all could have been a story of a very happy family, but something weird happened, leaving the land suddenly as a wasteland, without any animals or humans, apart from Rhiannon, Manawydan, Pryderi and Kikfa, of course. For a time, the four travelled to the borderlands, today known as England, and tried to make a living out of their crafting skills. And actually, they built a very successful business for themselves, since they were all very gifted in the art of crafting. But that, of course, also made the competitors very jealous, and after a few incidents, they were forced to return to Devet. Back there, Manawydan and Pryderi went hunting to feed their families, and they found and hunted a magical white boar, which they chased to a newly built castle made of glass. While Manawydan was skeptical and advised Pryderi not to enter the building, Pryderi was just too curious and entered anyways. He found a beautiful golden bowl in the castle, but as soon as he touched it, he was trapped by it, unable to let go. Well, of course, seeing his friend's fate, Manawydan returned to his wife Rhiannon as quick as he could in search for help. Rhiannon scolded her husband for being unable to help her son, but when she herself went to help him, she met the same fate also being trapped by the bowl. Unable to part with the bowl or to even speak now, Pridri and Rhiannon were helpless when mists started to form around the castle and making it vanish together with them. To make a long story short, the whole affair was just a trick by Gwal, the man Rhiannon was once to marry. On his behalf, the magician Ruith ap Cricot enchanted Rhiannon and transformed her into a mouse. Well, thankfully, in the end, Manawydan was able to make the magician release Rhiannon and her son, and also release Devid of the enchantments, making it habitable again. So, in the end, the little family was reunited and continued to live a peaceful life in Devid. And there you have it. Within the Mabinogion, Rhiannon is a proud, beautiful, and intelligent woman who has been through a lot of hard times. Her story inspired a lot of artists all over the world during the years. For example, the German folk band Faun, who wrote a song called Rhiannon. And there's also a video game called Rhiannon and the Four Branches, made by the British Arbor Studios. And she inspired a lot of other authors, musicians, and artists all over the world. And interestingly enough, in Australia, there is a politician called Lee Rhiannon, who was born as Lee Brown and adopted the name Rhiannon from Welsh folklore when she separated from her husband. And of course, today, still several pagan religions worship Rhiannon in one or the other way. She is often prayed to or invoked to bring creative impulses or to help with grief and loss. And so, the story of the Welsh fairy queen and goddess lives on until this day, inspiring people all over the world. Thank you very much for listening. If you like this video, please support my channel and hit the like button and subscribe. And if you happen to speak Welsh and caught me mispronouncing something, which is very likely since I think I swallowed my tongue somewhere in between, please let me know in the comments down below how to pronounce it correctly. Dir in fawr iawn. See you next time. Bye!